Okay, we found the problem.
You need to put your sausage fingers in there so they can see.
Oh, you want me to?
Alright, welcome back to CNC Equipment's YouTube channel. We have got another local logger's machine in the shop today. We love logger machines, don't we?
Loggers.
So customer states the machine is not steering to the left, the steering brake's not working, and it's suffering from some low transmission pressure issues sometimes. We get a light on the dash, it has no transmission pressure. So this is a John Deere 450G. I know it's kind of hard to tell, but it's been drugged through the woods a couple times. So these are good old tractors. They're all mechanical. So we've been doing a little investigative work, haven't we?
Yeah.
And so you guys don't know, I'll show you how this works in a little bit, but basically you got a 4-speed transmission inside of there. There's a brake band around each one of these sprockets basically inside there. So there's a clutch pack, it kicks that track in neutral, then a brake band grabs around there and clamps on that drum, locking that track up, allowing you to make a pivot turn. And there's actually adjustments inside of here. You guys can see, get you down in there. It's got a little star wheel in there, kind of like on a pickup truck or adjuster. So you can actually get these things running and take a screwdriver and crank that up. But that side has like a half inch of adjustment behind the nut, so it's pretty fresh. This side over here has got a bunch of adjustment, or a bunch that's, you guys can see it's got like a 1 inch of thread showing. So that tells me that brake band's worn, come apart or something. So we did actually put, did you help me do this?
I can't remember.
Three or four years ago, we actually put brake bands on this tractor. There's a metal band and it's got a fiber inside of it. And it broke one of the metal ears off on the band, pulled it off. So I'm guessing they're pretty rough on these things. We know how loggers are and stuff. So we've been draining the oil out of this dude. I got some more down there, but it's like black as gold and it's got metallic-y stuff in it. So
that's glitter.
Yeah, I'll show you.
Mechanic glitter.
That's the oil that's in it. It should be, you know, a light tan, brownish color and clean. And so when I seen that adjust all the way up, he says he keeps adjusting up and it just, it's wearing out quickly. So it doesn't last 3 or 4 passes and it needs adjust up again. So either something's come apart in there, the linings are gone or something, or it's just wore out. So if that oil's that dirty, it will allow stuff to work quickly too. So unfortunately, we're going to pull the winch off the back of here, and we're going to pull this back plate off right here and take a peek inside. The nice thing about these tractors, you can pull that back plate off and slide that transmission out there in a matter of about 30 minutes or so. There's a shaft through here. We can pull one out, the outside shaft, pull another one out, then we can pull the inner one inside the transmission. This thing literally just slides out in the rails. It's a very, very cool design, very mechanic friendly. So that's why we like working on these John Deeres, isn't it?
That's right.
So we're going to get the old log arch on here. I sold this guy's tractor a few years ago, so pretty sure we probably put that log arch on there too. We'll get it pulled off and we'll get the winch unbolted and see what's behind door number one. Alright, draining some oil out down there, that old nasty black stuff, and I found something in her pan down there. Mystery C-clip. I think I know where it goes.
Uh-oh.
So that come out of the drain hole. So I believe that is one of the brake pin retainers. Oh, it's a brake shoe in there, so that's not good. More bolts. You got one on the side? Oh, she just stuck, bud. Oh boy. This is a power in and power out winch, isn't it? We've got extra lines in here. Yep. Or that just made our job a little harder. Mm-hmm. We probably need to get the cap cap set. So we got to get these lines disconnected, capped. We got a control cable we got to undo here. She's loose, thankfully. So we'll have to get those lines capped, and we'll have to pull it out a couple inches or so and get to these lines, cap those, and there's one more drain line for this winch. So you guys have seen us work on a lot of winches. This is the same type of winch. It's what they call a 4000 winch. The other ones we've been working on previous videos are 4000 S's. The S stands for self-contained, meaning it has its own oil and everything in just the winch. These use oil from a transmission to supply the winch, so a little bit different deal there. This style winch is obsolete now. They do not make it, so I do keep the S models in stock. Basically, the S models fit anything 2000 or newer in a hydrostatic tractor. So we're gonna get those lines capped off and get some bolts pulled out, dude.
Need it.
All right, got all the oil drained out. I did take the main big drain line off. You guys will see it. Kevin's got the top two lines out. We've got two more lines for the power in and out function. We'll have to get it pulled back a little bit to get those loose. I couldn't, the one was trying to spin inside itself, so. What a dirty old mess. We might even fire up the little pressure washer and clean that off before we take that plate off, huh? You ready to come up under here and we'll get a chain around you? You ready, Bubby? Go up a little bit, Kevin. Up a little bit. Down a little bit. Back on up. Whoa. Come up. Lift it up. Come on up. Now back up a little bit. Give us a little more room on these hoses. Oop! That's good, shut her off. She's all dirty.
Mm-hmm.
We got a couple lines all up in this nastiness.
So that was the one?
We got two here.
Mm.
The bottom one, the adapter was spinning. Of course, you got the freaking fork right in the way now, don't you? Looks like I just got mad at it last time and cut the hoses and we put new hoses on it. We wouldn't do that, would we?
No.
Hmm. I'm sure they were nasty. Whoa, 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 whoa. Close, bud. Had my hose. Probably good. We probably ought to wash that off, too. So there we go. There's the big hose I took off underneath. This is actually just a return oil that goes in. Pressurized oil goes in, I think, here, if I'm not mistaken. Pressurize it up. It may go in here. I don't remember. This is a little different because it has a power in and out. If this was just a free spool only, it would just have one feed line and one drain line. So we're going to cap that stuff off. We're going to clean this stuff up a little bit before we pull this back plate off because we'll be exposing the transmission. We're going to use the little Giraffe Tools pressure washer. They sent us this thing. How long have we had that pressure washer?
A little
while. 6-8 months or something? So they sent me a couple of those, and so far the thing's holding up good, so it's nothing special, but you got a little quick job. It's not too bad. careful, I don't want a little hole in it. It's like one of them Billy Mays commercials. Awfully clean. Billy Mays, dude. Good job, bud. Good job. Boy, that pressure washer guy, he is something else.
He's awesome, isn't he?
He was good.
Billy Mays would be jealous.
Yes. Now,
R.I.P.
What's behind door number one?
That's a dirty, black, shiny, gritty,
oh,
broken yeah. snap ring.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Let's just make it up.
What about them big bolts?
Well, I'm going to take the camera and let you do the heck.
Oh, okay. All right. Well,
because that's on your
nothing
side.
Nothing new. Nothing new.
That's on your side, bud.
Okay.
See, I don't have that tool over here.
Oh, gotcha.
Now nobody can complain because we're working on something dirt. Now we just got a big old muddy mess.
That's right.
So this is just an access plate for the transmission. He's got the forks under it.
What is behind door number one?
Got a little pry bar or something. Gasket's got her on there, huh? I hear she's busting loose.
Purse sack.
Purse hit. There she comes. She's coming.
Not my finger.
Look at that big pry bar you got there. Not my $100 gasket.
Dang straight it ain't.
We might have to get some pig mats there, Bubby.
What? Piggy?
She's stuck on there with all of the onions. Don't worry, I'll get my side. Big old gasket. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's the transmission. Just that easy.
Let me remove my cutter. Yeah.
You get your forklift out, bud. What we got in here? Nice, dirty, shiny oil. Got to be more pieces to the snap ring in there. I'm going to do a little investigative theory.
I'm trying to light your own face.
It hurts.
Okay, we found the problem.
You need to put your sausage fingers in there so they can see.
Oh, you want me to?
You guys see that? I'm trying to get my finger. See that pin way back in there? It's coming out at an angle. Way back in here. It's probably because it's missing a snap ring.
Ooh.
Wouldn't you guess that?
I'm guessing so.
So, we just got to figure out.
Can we back that break off enough to get it to...
I'm thinking, Kevin, we can dig some of that dirt out and pull that plug out right up here.
Yeah.
And probably sneak that back in and back that break off. So that pin...
What you're saying is the washer guy sucked. He didn't get that.
Pretty much. That pin, I bet, is behind door number two right here. Well, guess what? We got denied. Those pins are in there, so it must be another pin that just sits inside there. That means we got to take all that crap out.
What?
Mm-hmm. I know sausage fingers ain't getting up in there on the inside.
I'll go elbow deep.
There's no way, bud.
I won't know what I'm doing, but I'll go elbow deep.
Yeah, you can throw your elbows in there, but...
Back that brake off. I'll shove it in there. We'll JV weld it.
Well, we can get it in there. We just can't get the E-clip in it because it's going to be against that case.
Ooh.
Yeah, bud. Well, the whole steering clutch has got to come out. It's almost easier to yank the whole transmission out. Mm-hmm. Sounds like a big job, but... Mm-hmm. You see any other way?
Oh, it's very moment.
It's not good. Yeah, not good at all. Some little $5 parts, and it cost us a wrenching session. Game talk.
When did you get your braking?
I don't know. Uh-oh, somebody. Oh, that's one of those scammers.
Ain't got a retainer?
All right, we're going to regroup, and we'll be back. Dirt?
No.
All right, so we're going to try something here. Kevin's running a bolt down over there, which is releasing the brakes because the brakes set automatically on these things. There's a big old spring up under there. He's cranking that bolt down. Don't have to pull that pin out. So we're going to try to do that, and then we're going to pull a couple pins off the side and try to rotate the assembly down this way. Maybe get it over enough where we can fix it. All right, so we got this unhooked here. You guys can see that. Kevin's backing that bolt back out. You guys can see it's kind of tight in here, so it's hard to show you. We're backing that bolt back up because we had the tension on the spring to get that pin out. So we're going to back that back out and take this bolt out up here. And we'll take this whole shaft out of here and get this thing out of our way. And then hopefully we can slide that brake band assembly down. So this right here is your steering clutch. There's a bunch of clutch backs in there. When you push the pedal down to pull your lever back just a couple inches, it's going to kick this, engage that clutch pack and kick this track in neutral. And if you keep on pushing down, it's going to grab a hold of this brake band and clamp around that. And that's what gives you a pivot turn on your track. So no computers needed on this dude. So yeah, that's good, Kevin. Now I can get that bolt loose up there. Okay, go ahead. That's the shim. Kevin just pulled out that pin out the side of the dozer there. It gave us a little more access. I can take this rod loose here a little better. Maybe we can get this dude. Oh, yeah. Well, maybe it may come around here. I think that's going to work for us, Kevin. I just need to get this thing out of our way. All right, I'm going to let go of that. Let's see if I can't lose a finger. There's our little pin. Nope, I got it.
I want to shove my sausages in here.
Do you?
Yeah.
You guys see right up there, there's the pin that's walked out. Mm-hmm. Oh boy. We'll just go ahead and take the whole thing out. All right. We'll take that up to the bench, bud, and we'll take a peek at her.
Oh, look, it fell in.
Oh, yeah?
See, done.
So we never ever had that piece out at all. So there's what that snap ring is supposed to look like. She just come loose, and you hold that up there, and we'll pull this pin out. And mm-hmm. You got that piece?
Yep.
We're going to have to inspect that and make sure it's not bent. So that pin's been sitting in there, what, about like that the whole time?
Mm-hmm. So they're getting just enough to get it to bite, but not enough to do anything.
Yep. Well, we're going to take a little look at that. I'm going to get some parts ordered tonight, maybe get them in the morning here. Mr. Andy can pick them up for us. Look at that paw's bent there a little bit, Kevin.
Paw.
So that locks in the brake band and shoves on it. That shouldn't really hurt anything, I think. We're gonna do a little more investigating, make sure nothing else is broken in here at all. So I told you guys originally we put brake bands on this thing a couple, two or three years ago. This ear right here actually broke off the brake band. So these bands are, they look excellent. Yep. Well, I think we need to order some parts, bud. What do you think? I wonder if that broke, when that broke last time, it put some stress on that E-clip, maybe? You know? I don't remember which side broke, but it seems like it was that side. I don't remember. Maybe it put some stress on that and caused it to fail on down the road. I'm thinking about ordering some more of these $5.50 parts. Don't look too bad, does it? I think you could file a polish this up a little bit and it'd be fine, because it just shoves in a piece of metal on the brake band. Okay. I don't see anything wrong with that. So yeah, this is a little adjuster. It adjusts your brakes up. So if you're looking at a tractor or something, you pull off that little peephole and you see a whole bunch of thread showing right there. That means the brakes are way worn down and that thing's adjusted up real far. So you just see like a quarter inch of thread showing, you've got good brake bands, are probably almost new. You see like an inch or more in there, that means she's about ready for brake bands, which is not a huge deal to change. Do what?
On that.
Yeah, on this. You get some of the old Cats or earlier John Deere's, you've got to pull all those tanks and stuff off and come up through the top, and it's a freaking mess. So, all right, I'm going to get some parts ordered. We do have to get, he wants to change the hydraulic transmission filters, and we're going to pull that suction filter strainer out too and inspect it. So I'm going to get some parts ordered here at the end of the day, and hopefully we'll be back in the morning. All right, Kevin just pulled the suction screen hose out from way down in the depths of the transmission. So this is what sucks all the fluid up to the pump. What we got on there?
I don't know. Crunchy.
Crunchy. Looks like it might be causing some of his pickup issues. Got some brake lining material. Just old crunchiness. Probably never been pulled out in its 30 years of life, has it?
What?
Nothing real big. No. We'll clean that up, put her back in. 10.89.
Oh.
All right, we got a new piece of hose cut for that suction screen strainer. Kevin's been cleaning. He's getting some little black pieces out of it. It's got a lot of material from over the years. You got to remember this winch uses the same oil as the transmission, so everything that the winch does, all the clutch packs, a lot of stuff goes through the transmission. But I'd say that's his problem there. He's losing a little suction, and that old hose was so hard, I'd say it could have been losing a little prime there. So this sits at the bottom of the transmission, and the pump has to suck oil from there. It has to suck up. So if you got anything that's kind of hard to pull up, it's not going to be happy about it, is it? If this rubber hose has a little bit of leak on it, it'll leak down overnight and it has to redo that whole process over again. But Mr. Randy's in town at John Deere picking up a couple snap rings. We're going to replace all these big ones. And we're about ready to put that back together, ain't we? Mm-hmm. And we got some new transmission filters coming from Napa too, or a transmission filter. He wanted a hydraulic filter replaced too, so we'll get that done while we're under there too. All right, we're down here in the floorboard of the beast. So we're way down in here taking that. I guess we're putting that back in, aren't we?
That's right.
We got everything cleaned up down in there. Kevin lost a bolt way down in there. I'd say that's what you call a RIP bolt, bud.
That's right.
You see anything?
No.
Well, you're going to feel for it, aren't you?
I'm going to give it to Ray Charles.
You know we got... Got any bolts, right?
Yeah.
It's probably be a different size head.
I don't see it, bud.
Oh.
Give up.
Just shiny things.
Just chasing shiny things.
Wet leaves.
Yep.
All right, we're going to get that dude slid back in there, back up to the pump. So, you ready? Sweet. You got that fitting loose on that pump?
Yeah. Yep.
That's what I'm seeing.
The object is not to touch all the dirt on the way in.
These people will tell you if you hit it or not.
Will they?
There's a little O-ring in there. We did put some sealant on it to help it out.
They're good people like it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Those clamps getting ready to leave the chat. All right, we're going to get that all tightened down. And then we'll move to the back. Hopefully Randy will be here.
Hammer.
All right, Mr. Randy got back with our new Eclipse, don't know what you call them. They're called clips. We're going to get those installed. We're going to try to get that dude wrestled up. We also got some new transmission filters and hydraulic filter too, so. Do good work.
That's a legit clip there.
All right, we need to change that one out too. We'll be brand new.
Are you ready?
I don't know if I got enough hands for this. And to get our people in there.
Oh.
Well, it's going to be a tight one. So I'm going to hook that dude in there and roll that dude around. I'm not sure if there's room for everybody. I got to get that up in there. You guys are going to have to get out of my way. Sorry. All right, got that back in there. We got one piece of the puzzle left. Try to bring you guys along here. Kevin's gonna shove the get you up here where you can see. I can't see. Bring that rod in a little bit, Kevin. Well, he's gonna bring it in. We'll back you up right there. Uh-oh. Grab my leg again. Okay, come on in a little bit. Come on in. I gotta slide two shims in the other side once you get in closer. Alright, hold up. Okay, go ahead. You what? Hang on a second. Yeah, we're fine. Go ahead. You're not all in, are you? Huh? Yep, that's it. Okay, got that in there. I just got to hook up this one more linkage here. Kevin will have to, I'm probably going to back those brakes off some and help us there, Kevin. I'll start with the part of my fingers. Is that ready? You've never been my age, bud. You can't say that.
I hear that.
Huh. Okay.
You both off on that?
No. Yep, I got her. Got her, maybe. Get this pin slid in here. How about that new clip? Alright, we're just going to stick one new clip in here, and we'll be DUN in there. Clean out a little bit. A new clip, we're going to clean it out a little bit, and then are we ready to put the old transmission plate in? We've got to get that brake adjuster bolt adjusted back down, right? That release bolt, but yeah. So we can put that back plate on and start this dude up if we want to before we put the winch on, or we just trust ourselves, don't we?
Oh, we trust ourselves.
Always. All right, got that cleaned out. I'm going to show you guys real quick. All you got to do to pull these transmissions out, when I told you earlier, you got to take a little triangle cap with three bolts out there. You can pull out that inner shaft right there through the outside. then that shaft that's in the transmission, you can thread a rod in it, pull it all the way out, and then the rod that's in this side, you can actually pull back through the transmission. It will stay in there. Then you take these four bolts out right here, take these washers off the end of the rail, 10 millimeter, take four bolts out there. This whole thing slides out these rails right here, just slick as can be. Very nice design. You can take a forklift and put your two forks right there and slide that dude right out. Very, very simple. Get that thing out and get to it real easy and rebuild it. You got forward and reverse clutch pack there on top. And then you got first and third and second and fourth on another one. I may be saying that wrong, but anyway, they're very, very simple to work on. So there's a simple ring and pinion gear there in the back side. So maybe one day we'll get one of these that's broken. We'll take it out and fix it. But we got that all cleaned up. The red bead goes towards the plate, bud. Right here.
Red.
Oh, you got red on both sides. I don't know what to tell you then.
Towards the plate.
Guess it don't matter.
Wrong.
Bubby, you're backwards. That looks better.
Ding, 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 ding.
All right, we'll get that in there. Well, I guess since we're still waiting on the transmission filter, apparently somebody ordered the wrong one. I don't know who that was. Don't know. Anyway, we'll go ahead and put the winch and everything on because we trust ourselves that much.
Winch. Oh, we know it works.
Yeah. All right, you ready, bud?
Let's do it.
Big bolt.
Big bolt.
Big bolt. So you guys may be noticing we're putting in bolts where the winch goes. The reason we're doing that, we're making sure everything's lined up in that plate. A guy could get that out of cattywampus out, right? So we'll tighten the ones up that we can now, and then we'll clean that plate off a little bit and slam the winch on there, and hopefully the bolt should twist right in.
That's right.
Oh, bud, I got some caps on here, bud. Whoa, horsey. I thought you prepared the winch for shipment. Huh? Do you not prepare the winch for shipment?
No, I did not. I prepared the tractor.
What are you doing, Uncle Scott?
No, I'm going to take this heater over here.
Up, you know, if you wasn't so grumpy, you wouldn't be cold, right?
Yeah. That's why I'm grumpy, because I'm cold.
Now you're going to be happy because you're going to be warm. Somebody said Uncle Scott looks grumpy all the time in the comments. Uncle Scott's not grumpy. He just looks grumpy. He's like an old grumpy cat. You ready, bud?
You grumpy old cat.
We got to come in here and we got to hook these lines up. Shift back to me. A little more that way. Whoop. Come on in. Alright, got some bolts started. We got it started in that PTO shaft out there. I'm gonna go underneath, gotta hook that one big hose up. Return drain hose. Down here in the dark. Oh my gosh. Let me pull a board out, bud. Alright, I got distracted on the phone call and I just went to town tightening up this old hose here, didn't I?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I guess we probably need to put, do you want to put bolts down here, Kevin, and get this lined up? Is that what you're trying to do?
Yeah, I just want to make sure it's all good.
You want to give me the, I guess, then you can run the tops in tight. Is that what you're thinking?
Maybe.
So we got this hitch we got to put back in here. You got more bolts? So we're just going to get these lined up kind of like we did with the plate, and then we'll tighten the winch up, and then we'll bring it hitch in there. You got that wrench? I probably need a couple for the other side too. Did you get all those started? Okay, there you go. Now we can pull her up tight, then we'll come back down here and take these bolts out, and we'll throw that old nasty hitch on there. All right, we got the bottom. That used to be a hitch, they cut it off, but got the winch all on, the bottom plate on there. That does not necessarily have to go on there, but they want it back on there for protection. Kevin's bringing the old log arch in here. There's a pin to that for this. Driver's side. Hey bud, you're backwards. Alright, got the old log arch on there. Kevin's gonna get the snap rings on there. We still gotta put the transmission filter in and fill it full of oil here and see what happens. Alright, we got the filters on. We're filling her full of oil. 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 I don't know how you say oil. Oil. This thing holds, I have to look it up, it's like 20 some gallons, and the winch holds oil too. We'll get her all full, we'll have to fire it up, and we'll have to adjust that brake over there because we've had it all out of whack. And then, hopefully, she's good to go. Alright, got her on. Kevin's going to start it up, and hopefully our transmission pump picks up primer here. He'll probably release the brakes, and we'll see the pedals pop up when it gets fluid. So, you got the fuel pulled back on? That's got that mechanical fuel kill. Because it's a fire dozer. Give her a little bit of throttle. I got the pedals come up. We've got to let all that oil fill this winch housing up. There's actually a tube that comes up here, so it has to fill this whole housing up with the oil. Then it drains back into the transmission. You gotta check east, west, and front, and of course, we'll get this checked, and then we'll get the brakes adjusted. Parking brake off, and it has to be running to adjust those up. Kevin's going to hit that little clicker in there. And remember, we had all that apart. Get these up too high. The first section is actually the clutch. If you get them up too high, then the clutch won't break free first. So. And you tighten that other side up a couple twists. So I want to get these where they're sitting even. You can see that right side's down a little bit too low. So you got to spin that wheel down towards you now, Kevin. Probably from the top. He's cranking up. About two more clicks or so, two or three. Tighten those plugs up. Oh, we're shut the key off. We should be good. So he's just adjusting through that big hole, that star wheel thing in there, to get those sitting upright. So, what do you think? We're all done, ain't we?
Yep.
Winch work, we did try that. Fluid's all good, so. Hopefully you guys liked another logging video. Everybody loves logger videos,
hey,
don't they?
Them loggers must make so much money. Look at that seat. Where that billfold sits. See how it's all chewed out like that?
Big old billfolds in
there.
Turn
the
seat
ahead.
We're not upholsters. Yeah. Well, hopefully you guys liked the cool video today. It's a little something different, I guess, out of the norm. If you did, hit that like button. Give us a big thumbs up because it helps us out a lot. And we're getting close to 100K. 100,000 subscribers.
Oh, I thought $100,000. No. I was going to say, let's talk.
Maybe. So... if you guys would, if you've not done so, you might consider subscribing and help us out so we can reach that milestone. So we'll catch you guys next time.